Good morning and welcome to episode 18 of CoActive at Home. This is probably going to be our last episode of CoActive at Home because hopefully in the next few weeks, further into September, we might be able to bring back together some groups of people, which is really exciting for us. But we also understand it's quite overwhelming and a little bit daunting. But we feel quite confident that having you with us, helping us through this transition phase, will make sure that we get the right shape of what needs to happen for us as artists and you as creative and CoActive as one big company. So yeah, welcome to episode 18. I'm going to do some best and worst with you really quickly because I'd love to know what you've been up with. You're never going to guess, but it's harvest time at the allotment. And so everything we've been growing, we're all starting to pick. We've had sweet corn and cucumbers, courgettes, this big, potatoes, so many potatoes. We've had runner beans, bolotti beans, French beans, tomatoes, and I've got pumpkins bigger than my head. So that's my good news. My other good news is that I'm going to go to the seaside this next weekend. I'm going away to Cornwall for a week with the two children, Tilly and Ollie and Andy. So it's going to be lovely. I'm looking forward to it. My worst, it's been a bit rainy today. The rain's been coming sidewards and upwards and downwards and left and right in the woods. So yeah, the rain's a bit miserable today, but it's fine because I'm sure the sun will shine soon. I'd love to hear your best and worst. In the episode today, we've got quite a few things. It's a little bit of a mashup. We've got Jodie and Mel both doing bits of art. Jodie's looking at some stuff that he found about on YouTube, two artists that came together creating a project called Dear Data. And Mel is looking at taking ordinary objects, placing them on a piece of paper and drawing a brand new thing around them. We've also got some dancing from Sophie, a little bit of cheerleader, and we've got some balance work with Mel. And with me, I'm going to share a music video that I made with a group of young people, and I'm going to teach you some of the song. And I think also we'll have a little bit of a drama warm-up and maybe a game. All right, I hope you enjoy the episode. We've been asked to share a lovely clip from Love to Meet You. They look like a great organisation.
At the moment, we can't see our friends and meet up with people like we normally would because of coronavirus. We have to do things differently to stay in touch. That's why HFT's friendship and dating service called Love to Meet You are now running events and hangouts online and on the phone instead. It's a way to meet up with people, have fun and make new friends. You can enjoy things like coffee mornings, quizzes, gaming, food and recipe challenges, and Love to Meet You's Got Talent contest. There are things you can join in with on Facebook, like pampering and Gogglebox events. The events are based on what members would like to do, so if you've got an idea, we'd love to hear it. The team can also give people a friendly call or text to have a chat and check in. Here's some of our members to tell you more.
I'm getting on really, really well. I'm loving it.
It's a big difference. I'm much happier. Anybody who's got a learning disability can join. But you might be nervous at first. You will enjoy yourself.
It's made my life really good, and I'm really enjoying it.
Interested? Get in touch with the Love to Meet You team to find out more. Call 01 27 46 559 56. Leave a message with your name and telephone number and someone will call you back. Or you can email the team at lovetomeetyou@hft.org.uk. Anyone with a learning disability and or autism can join in, and you don't have to pay anything, it's free. But remember, there might be charges for using your phone to join in, so it's good to check this first. You'll need a computer, tablet or phone and access to Skype, Facebook and group calls. But don't worry, we can support you with this. Just let us know if you don't have access to these or you're stuck or unsure. Love to Meet You normally run events out and about and we'll be getting out there again when we can. But for now, see you online.
everyone. So we've been doing some dance therapy at home to keep us all going. One of our favourite songs is Cheerleader. So can you remember how it goes? This is Ariana, you might have met her. So we come down. Dun, dun, don't we? Oh no, we come out even. Got that wrong, it's because the music's not on. So we're going to come out, punch, punch, outside, punch, punch, down, down, punch, punch, then up, up, punch, punch, and then out. So just imagine you've got pom-pom, so you can do it sat down, or if you can, stand up, because we will be doing some leg work. And there's some freestyle sections as well, but the main thing is put on the music and just keep moving at home. So let's go. So let's get in that comfortable position, shoulders rolled back, hand on hip. I'm gonna get those hip hits going soon, aren't we, Ari? Let's go. Might wanna bring out your snake arms. So pretend you're a bird. The stage gone.
Yeah, yeah. She is always in my corner right there. When I want all these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty when you're gone.
That's it.
Do you need me? Do you think I'm protected?
Okay, jump. Let's go for it. Oh, oh.
She's always right there when I'm.
Jump, jump, jump. And out to the side. That's. Okay, hands down. That's it, keep going. Okay, get the wizard wand out.
Do you need me? Do you think I'm pretend?
Okay, get jumping, lots of energy, let's go. Oh. Side, side, down, down, up, up, and out. Okay, jump. And down, brilliant. Okay, get rolling those hands. Okay, we like do snake arms on this bit, don't we? Bring your arms outside, side. And you might want to pretend you're playing the trombone. Or trumpet, you can tell I don't do music. And have a freestyle. You can go into the splits like Ari if you want to. So this is freestyle. Let's get jumping on the spot. Keep jumping, lots of energy. Imagine we're all together in a tube. And bring your hands down. So we're going forward, forward, out, out, down, down, up, up, and out. Keep marching on the spot whilst we're doing that. Okay, freestyle section again. Or you can even imagine you're a cheerleader. And finish it off. Finishing pose. Well done, everyone. I'd love to know what your favourite music is. Let us know and we'll try and do a little dance to it, won't we? So we hope you're all keeping well, keeping strong, and keep dancing.
Hi, CoActive. An exciting, I hope you enjoyed the DVD last week of us moving in. It's very exciting. I tell you what, there's quite a lot of work to do. We discovered a potential problem with the electrics, so we need to get that sorted out. So we're going to have to be patient with us. We need to get the space sorted out. But the next step is we want to talk to you all about coming in and helping to paint and prepare the space. So we want to form little working parties, and we're going to be talking to you about whether you're interested in doing that and how to set that up safely. So that's good. For the art activity today, I'm obviously really busy with the unit and everything and the riding stuff. So just a quickie, and I've pulled off a little video off of YouTube, from two women that do something very interesting. So I'm going to show that now. But first, before we watch it, just want to say the video moves quite fast. It's quite complicated in some ways because they talk and they use some long words, and I've had to watch it a couple of times to understand what they're saying. So don't worry about understanding it all, but look at the images and look at what they draw and the little symbols they use. I think that's the most interesting thing. So watch what they do, and then I'm going to set a task for you that's like what they do, but simpler. Okay, let's watch the video.
We've added a link below so you can watch the video that Jodie's talking about.
I'm going to send out today three pieces of paper, a pink one, an orange one, and a white one. And on the pink one is going to be a question, and it says face mask, ? And there's a little picture of a face mask. And here we can draw little symbols to show how many times we've been wearing a face mask, which will actually be quite useful for us in when we have conversations about what we need to do when we come back to the space. So yesterday I went to the squash club with Diggory and we played squash, and there when we went in I didn't know who I was going to meet, so I put on a face mask. So I'm going to draw a face mask. You can come up with any symbol you like. This is quite a complicated face mask, but you can come up with any symbol you like. Oh, don't like that bit. You can come up with any symbol you like for the face mask. You could just draw a triangle if you want, or a circle, or a squiggle. But come up with a symbol for face mask. So I wore a face mask, and then we got in and realised that something wasn't working, so we had to go back and ask somebody a question. So then I put on the face mask again. But I only wore it for a little while, so I'm just drawing. Actually, that was just really quick, that second time. So I'm just drawing another face mask. And then later on, I was thinking about ordering some reusable ones, face masks. And I tried it on and I wore it for a bit of a longer time. So now I'm going to draw a bigger face mask. So altogether during the day, I wore a mask three times yesterday. And I'm going to put a box around that to show that happened in a day, three times. I can then do, at the end of today, I can do today. And each day I can record how many times I've worn a face mask. Easy, right? So on the orange piece of paper, we've got the question, mood. You know, what kind of mood are you in? And mood are you in? And there's a smiley face with an up arrow. And there's a sad face with a down arrow. And for this, we're calling them infographics, maybe. For this graphic, we're going to use arrows to describe how we felt. So I'm thinking about yesterday. And I woke up. And generally, when I wake up, I feel a bit down and a bit heavy. It takes me a while to come round. So I'm just drawing an arrow to represent a down arrow to show that I was a bit down. And then the first thing I did was to make a cup of tea, and I sat and I had a prayer time, a time to pray. And that kind of took me up, and that kind of leveled me out. My prayer time, it was good because the stuff that I was feeling grumpy about, it helps me to realise it's not that important. And then I had some breakfast, which was all right. And then helped Natalie set up her artwork, which was good. But I'm going to go, that turned the corner because I had to write some messages and I couldn't spend the time I wanted to with Natalie. Actually, the time I should have with Natalie. So that brought me down a bit. And then what happened? And then I was doing messages. And that's all right, I quite like doing that work, but if I do it too much, it starts to send me downwards a bit, and it
starts to make me feel heavy, and makes my brain go foggy. But then I went to the squash club with Diggory and we had a game of squash and it was fun and we laughed and we had a good amount of talking. So that for me is a big, in fact I'm going to make it a big fat up arrow there. I'm going to colour it in maybe. So using different sorts of arrows. And when I was at the squash club, they offered me a subscription and I need to get a membership because they're not having guests in at the moment with coronavirus. And it was a good deal and I've decided to do it. And then that meant coming home and that meant going on and printing out a form and filling out a form and scanning in the form. And it was a bit complicated. And that started to send me down again, a little bit, just a little bit. It just makes me feel a bit heavy and a bit, ugh, rather not have to do it. It's just one of those things you have to do that you'd rather not. And then in the evening, we watched The Truman Show. I've not seen that for years. And that's got a lovely, happy ending where he finds the wall and the boat breaks through the wall and he climbs the stairs and escapes. So there's some arrows about how I was feeling yesterday. And I'm going to put that in a box to show that was one day. Do you think you could have a go with that? So we've got face masks, moods. And then if you want to make up one of your own and do some symbols about information, about things you've noticed through the day, it might be how many birds you've seen. It might be how many times you've opened the fridge. It might be to do with, I don't know. It could be how many doors you've been through. It could be how many times you've been out of breath. It could be how many different people you've waved to or said hello to that day. It can be anything, whatever you like. So there you go. I hope that's a nice activity. And what it does, it gives us something to think about, and it gives us something to talk to each other about, or to talk to other people about. You could, if it wasn't too personal, you can show them, look, I've been doing this bit of artwork. Look, this is how many times I've been wearing masks. This is how I've been feeling. Okay? Have a go. And we'll see you next time. Bye.
Mel is sharing some work of Christoph Nyman. He's a brilliant artist that takes everyday things and turns them into beautiful bits of drawings.
Okay, so I've just shown you some pictures done by an illustrator called Christoph Nyman. And as you can see, he used ordinary objects and made them into something different. So that's my art challenge for you today, to find some some boring objects and make another picture out of them by looking at them from a different angle. So I'm gonna have a go now. I am not very good at this, but I think you guys are going to be good at it. Okay, this is my idea. So these are bean cans. You can use other objects, you don't just need to use bean cans. But we're going to do bean cans and we're going to do a car. Well, Rick's going to do a car. I'm going to watch him. He even gets to use two hands. Maybe I include my rubbish attempt just so you can see another option of doing it with one hand not very well. There we go. The person in the car. Quite small, aren't they?
They're quite a small person.
They are quite a small person.
I deserve that myself.
Ah, well, just keep going with it. Is a small person, a miniature person.
Yeah.
Trying a very big car.
Yeah, yeah, that's okay.
Maybe standing up. Maybe having
maybe
they've got another person underneath doing the pedals. They're so small.
Oh, really nice time though. Look sort of quietly confident.
Yeah. Well, they've got another person doing another part, aren't they?
Yeah.
Very nice. Is the steering wheel attached?
Could be.
Could be attached.
Could be if you're traditional, I suppose. I think about art maybe different than you.
Yeah, yeah. It keeps me to focus on your shoulder.
There. How's that?
That is magnificent. Oh, it's going to change the angle. Oh.
There you go.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's really beautiful. Thank you very much. Excellent. You guys have a go now. All right then, bye-bye.
Hi, CoActive. So I'm gonna give you a physical challenge this morning. I hope you're enjoying how massive my hair has got over lockdown. Yeah, all a bit, it's kind of got a bit of a 70s feel going on. I quite like it. It's not what you think. I know what your hair's doing this over lockdown. But yeah, mine's just getting ever huger and massive. Anyway, enough about my hair. So we're going to do, we're going to look at balance today. And so you're going to play around with your own balance, a bit of just a challenge. So this is just a little bit of a thing. So you can't see my feet, but you can feel your own. So I'm going to stand up nice and straight. And we're going to start by getting a neutral position. So I've talked about this lots of times with you, but I want you to feel like you've got a helium balloon attached to the top of your head. Oh, if I stand under this lampshade, that can be my helium balloon. There you go, and it's pulling you up. And you feel that as it pulls you up to the top of your head, all your spine lengthens. If you pull your chin just a little bit in as well, you can feel that really straightens and lengthens your spine. That's good. And your shoulder blades, a bit of a roll back. They should be feeling like they're moving down your spine and moving in towards your spine. So if your arms are, if you can see your fingers in your peripheral vision, so that means when you're looking forward, you can kind of see wiggly fingers. It probably means that your shoulder blades are in the right position. So they're not lifted up, they're not rolled back too much. Got a looseness in your shoulders and your neck. You can see them. I end up feeling quite a lot of tension and sometimes draw my shoulders in, but what you really want to do is have them nice and wide across your chest. And then we think about our pelvis. What we don't want is this position here. So we don't want our bum sticking out. We want to pull it down. So if you had a tail sticking out, you don't want it sticking up, you want it dropping down like imagine a big kangaroo tail dropping down onto the floor. Okay, now that's a really good position. And we're thinking about our legs being about hip width apart, facing forward. Can't see mine, but you can see my legs, my hips. I want you to wiggle your toes. I'm doing this with my toes. Wiggle them along. If you can take your shoes and socks off, that'd be really good because you can
really feel them, drum them along, spread them out, because shoes can be quite restrictive. Kind of squish them in. And you can feel that your weight is in your heels and your balls of your feet. So if that's your heel of your, so that's my heel of my hand, but think of that as the heel of my foot and the balls. So really you don't want much weight in your toes. Your toes shouldn't be whole, your toes should be quite relaxed. So I play, move your weight around a bit. So if you can move your weight to the different, sometimes we say corners of our feet, that sounds strange because they're not really rectangular. But when I say that, I mean each corner of our heel and each corner of our ball. I don't want you gripping with your toes really. I want them to be as relaxed as possible. And I want to see is, whoa, have a play with where your weight's going now. Whoa, feel that kind of off balance and coming back again. Whoa, how far back can you go? You can use your hands and your arms. Whee! Where's it going to take you? Where's send your body as off balance as you can before you can come back again. Now you can do it with your eyes closed if you want. You can feel it. You don't have to go very far before you feel that difference where the weight is in your feet. And then find a spot where it's all balanced. And I would say, this is a helpful image, you've got about 60% of your weight in your heels and about 40% in the balls of your feet. So it's not quite 50-50, it's a little bit more on your heels. That's a really good place to be. And your ribs are relaxed, and your shoulders are relaxed, and your neck's relaxed, and you feel long. Yeah, that's a really good position. Now, this is my challenge for you then. My challenge for you is to, now you know what it feels like to be centered, to feel balanced, I want you to play with that balance. So think about how far off can you go? Whoa. Oh, and then bring yourself back up again. Where can you balance? Like, what positions can you do before you need to come back again? And it might be a bending one, it might be a really stretchy, bendy one. And yeah, I've got a lot of weight in my heels now. Whoa! I might be looking up to the ceiling, I might be going back. I might be going to the side. So have a bit of a play with that and play and see how brave you can be. And actually, sometimes it's really nice to feel yourself go and fall with it as well. So feel that fall. So one challenge is to feel yourself going and come back. And another one is to go with the fall. And really feel your body catching. Which feels quite nice in itself. And see how much challenge you can do. So it's a bit of a play. Okay, so that's my challenge for you today. All right then, take care.
You might remember a few weeks ago that Mel did some dance pieces with inanimate objects. Well, there was one that didn't come through to me that was all about a chocolate bar. So we slipped that one in there because it's lots of fun and definitely worth a watch. Enjoy.
Thank you.
going to do a little bit of a warm-up because we're going to do some singing in a little minute. So we're going to warm our bodies and warm up our faces and our lips and our mouths and our voices. So to begin with, let's do the old classic, the picking of apples, the one that Mel did, all right? The one that where we used to pick the apples from above. We'll count to eight and then we'll do them forward and to the side and behind, down below, through the legs. Are you ready for eight? So we're gonna reach up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You better be joining in to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. To the floor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And between your legs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Gosh, I'm rubbish at this. 'Cause our faces a little rub. Wake them up. Give them a little slap. Oh, squeeze these bits here. Any tension? Pitter patter all over. Pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter. Pitter patter, pitter patter, pitter patter. Lovely. Stick your tongue out. Shake your face. I'm gonna do this in slow motion. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Let's do the Barry's old favourite. The tip of the tongue, the teeth and the lips. The tip of the tongue, the teeth and the lips. Now I've taught you a few tongue twisters in lockdown. We've got the skunk sat on the stump and the stump thought the skunk stunk and the skunk thought the stump stunk. We've got Wayne watches walruses in Wales. We've got two witches watching two watchers. Which watches which watch? So I hope you got really good at them. But let's go back to an old one. She sat upon the balcony. She sat upon the balcony. Inexplicably mimicking him hiccuping. Inexplicably mimicking him hiccuping. And amicably welcoming him in. And amicably welcoming him in. She sat upon the balcony, inexplicably mimicking him hiccuping and amicably welcoming him in. Your turn. She sat upon the balcony, inexplicably mimicking him hiccuping and amicably welcoming him in. Let's sing a quick song to warm ourselves up. Sometimes what you're looking for may be nearer than you think it is. Your turn. Sometimes what you're looking for may be nearer than you think it is. When you're looking so high in the sky, when you're looking so high in the sky, you're missing what's right on your doorstep. You're missing what's right on your doorstep. All together. Sometimes what you're looking for maybe nearer than you think it is. When you're looking so high in the sky, you're missing what's right on your doorstep. Sometimes what you're looking for maybe nearer than you think it is. When you're looking so high in the sky, you're missing what's right on your doorstep. Are you in good voice today? I do hope so. A song called Only You. It was written originally by Yazoo. You might remember her. She sang The Only Way Is Up. It's not the song. That's not what we're singing. But you might know this song more because Alison Moyet sang it and the Flying Pickets sang it. So I'll sing a line and then you can sing it back to me And then I'll sing the next line and you can sing that back to me. And then I'll tell you what, we'll probably sing the whole thing through. I'm only going to teach you the first verse and the chorus. But yeah. And then maybe you can sing along with the girls in the music video that I'm going to share. Okay. Looking from a window above, it's like a story of love. Can you hear me? Looking from a window above, it's like a story of love. Can you hear me? Came back only yesterday, I'm moving further away. Won't you near me? Came back only yesterday, I'm moving further away. Won't you near me? All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another day. All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another day. And all I ever knew, only you. And all I ever knew, only you. Okay. Do you want to sing the whole thing together? Okay, all right. Looking from a window above, it's like a story of love. Can you hear me? Came back only yesterday, I'm moving further away. Won't you near me? All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another day. And all I ever knew, only you. I can't wait till I get back in a room together and sing. Hopefully, fingers crossed, it won't be long. But for now, sing along with the girls in the music video. That'd be great.
Looking from a window above, it's like a story of love. Can you hear me? Came back only yesterday, I'm moving further away. Won't you hear me?
All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another day. And all I ever knew, only you.
Sometimes when I think of a name, when it's only a game. And I need you. Listen to the words that you say. It's getting harder to stay when I see you.
All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another day. And all I ever knew, only you.
All I needed was the love you gave.
All I needed for another day.
And all I ever knew, only you.
This is gonna take a long time, and I wonder what is mine. Can't take no more. Wonder if you'll understand. It's just the touch of your hand behind a closed door.
All I needed was the love you gave. All I needed for another day. And all I ever knew,
only you.
And that's it. 18 weeks. 18 weeks of connecting with art and dance and drama and music, of singing around our living rooms and dancing through our days at home. Fingers crossed we'll be back together soon. Might be in a slightly different way, but we will be together again soon. Take care till I see you next time. Bye-bye.